everyone, and welcome to the Mini Toy Love channel. And today I have some Craft City by Karina Garcia slime to unbox and review. Two are Walmart exclusives, the Poppy Pink pre-made slime, as well as the Berry Blue. And then I also have a cool set of what's called the Seaside Taffy. It comes with blue raspberry, watermelon, peppermint, and cherry. So it's a really cool 4-pack, and I want to thank the company for sending me these items to review. So let's go ahead and get started. First up, I want to start with the pretty Berry Blue on the back. It gives you a little bit more about Craft City. And here's the container. So these are resealable, and then they have the seal that you can break. So it's a really gorgeous blue. And again, you need to stretch this pretty slowly, but it does feel like store-bought slime where it has that little jiggle to it and kind of a slow stretch, or else it tears. And this one has a very light blue raspberry scent. You can also get some pokes. Again, it just feels like you have to stretch it very, very slow or else it breaks. It has a gorgeous color to it. Next up is Poppy Pink. And this one looks like it's going to be the same sort of glossy texture. It is definitely a very pretty pink. This one crumbles a bit too. And it's a little bit hard to get out of the container. So I'm not sure why this one kind of broke apart and was hard to get out, but here's what I could manage. Again, it has a really pretty color. Same texture. It does have that sort of rubbery, jiggly feel to it. You can get some bubble pops, but again, as for stretching, it's not too good. You can get some clicks, which those are always fun. Not sure what this one smells like, kind of fruity, but it's very, very faint. On to our Seaside Taffy pack. Next up we have a blue raspberry. Oh, it has a cool kind of marble swirl design going on. This one's definitely a different sort of texture, and it smells super strong. It actually smells more like a sour blue raspberry type of candy. So it does feel like it breaks apart. I'm not sure if it's sort of like a DIY one where it has like a clear layer and then maybe more of that creamy butter type of layer. So let me get some out. But again, I find this very hard to stretch and play with. It's pretty to look at. I do like how you can mix things in. It also has that rubbery texture. So it's definitely a holdable slime, something to like squish and play with, but you can't really stretch it, and there's no bubble pops or poking going on. But you can kind of do this. It's almost like having a stress ball. This reminds me, if you've seen videos on like Wish slime and stuff like that, it kind of feels similar to those types of slimes. Next we have Cherry Slime, and one thing I noticed, if you guys see that, it's like moving around in there. It has one layer and a bottom layer, so I'm not sure if it's like separated, but we're gonna find out. Hopefully it won't make too much of a mess. If it's too liquefied, I may not pour it on my table. I've never really seen a store-bought slime do that. So this slime smells really good. It smells like cherry candy, but I think something happened to it along the way. It may have had those layers that separated, but this is pretty much liquefied. Definitely has a deep, deep dark color, almost like a brownish red. It's so dark. I'm just gonna leave it as is though. I think the layering was cool, but it just didn't mesh together. I'll try to play with it inside the package. If you look closely at my fingers, it actually leaves this weird residue. Yeah, that's not good. Okay, let's hope the peppermint slime is better. Okay, it looks pretty creamy, like the blue one. It feels like a more thick butter slime type quality, but it has that same texture where it does kind of clump together and pull apart. So you can poke it when it's in its container, and it smells like a peppermint candy cane. And the last one is watermelon slime from our Seaside Taffy series. So this one looks to be the same texture as our blue raspberry. Even in a small little thing, it's not very, very stretchy. Looks like it had some marbling color that you can mix together too. And it smells like watermelon candy, like Jolly Ranchers, which smells really good. But again, you can't really stretch it too much. But you can squish it. Here's another look at our Craft City slimes. You guys will have to let me know which was your favorite one. Leave me a comment below. As for me, I like the look and the idea. The smell's pretty good, but as for playability, I don't know if I got a bad batch, but I think there's a lot better store-bought slime or slime shop slime that you could buy for the money. So unfortunately, I wasn't too big of a fan of any of these. I think this one had the best scent though. So that'll do it for this video. I want to thank you guys so much for watching. I appreciate it, and I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.